a little. And I have a fresh, hopefully a sweet banana. That's a kid playing or a cat out of it. And I already have some butter. Butter in the bowl. This is that instant cream of wheat. Take like 5 minutes to make. The banana smells so good. Gotta bring some nice sounds. Eating sounds. Boxes over there with stuff that my spirit lights has sent me. I'm just excited. Thank you. happy birthday to all of the August babies.
Yes.
Happy, happy birthday. July. A lot went on in July. I'm so glad I'm out the mud, but at the same time, July was definitely a blessing month. It's nice and quiet today. I'm enjoying the peace too. Just in case you didn't know, Umbrella freaking season 2 is freaking out. Oh my god, I'm on episode 1. So I'm still on one, because it was so action packed and going so fast, I gotta go back to really like understand everything that's going on. But I think in the first episode, and the last season, they all went back in time so that they could stop their sister from destroying the world. But they ended up in the freaking 60s. Ended up in the 60s, like either a year apart or a few years apart. stuck in a little boy's body. Number one is the guy who looked like the Hulk. Yeah. But, child, oh my God, Diego is in a crazy home. And the brother, that's just what should I call him? Centric. I think it's another barcode of that, but I can't think of it right now. Yeah. He dating like an older lady. He got people worshiping him and following him. And the black sister. I can't remember her name right now. She's married, I think, to a black activist. Yeah. And the other sister, she got hit by a car, the one that destroyed the world in season one. She got hit by a car. She's living with some woman and her kid. She lost her memory. Season one, she was the strongest, but she didn't know she had powers, and she was mad with them once she found out. So the whole purpose was to go back in time, stop her from destroying the world, and her finding out she got powers. And she's not like them, like she got powers. She is the power. She is the power. Oh my God. Oh my God. So freaking good. Season two gonna be nuts. I already know. Season, you know, in season one, the father had died. In this season, he's alive. He's back in the 60s with them. On Netflix. My son paid for Netflix, right? And when we was out, I'm trying to remember, I can't remember, but we was somewhere. We was on our way on a road trip to Nadine's birthday and getting gas. The bank had put a stop to his car. Just found out that they used this card at a gas station. Then from there, they started making all these crazy charges. Like, one of the first charges they made was like $40, then $30, then $300, just making all these charges on his card, right? And he was upset. He's like, dang, I hate when something like that happened, because I got stuff that automatically come out of my account. So Netflix was was one of the ones that automatically came out of scam, so I guess the card didn't work. And we didn't have Netflix anymore, which we had canceled our Netflix. And so my son went and paid for it. And I guess they didn't get the money, so my daughter was like, we not paying for Netflix. Child, we saw Umbrella too. It's like Netflix. We paid for Netflix. Oh my god. So now I gotta check out. I gotta try to find everything that I haven't watched. You know why I can anyway. It's on Netflix. If you haven't checked it out, you gotta check it out. You can check it out, watch it with me. That way, if I'm talking about it, you know what I'm talking about. Child, why the black girl ended up in, I think for her, she ended up in 1963. And it said whites only when she went inside the store. Child, the man didn't even say that to her. He just looked at the sign. He just pointed up at the sign. She like, what? I was like, girl, get the heck up out of here. And what was another funny scene? No, Diego, I can't believe he was in a straitjacket. Oh my god, he's the guy that uses the knives. Like, he's a knife thrower. I don't know what you call people who know how to throw a knife and all of that, you know, good with knives. He's one of them people. Okay. Child. They have in that straight jacket. I was like, oh my god, Diego, get out of that straight jacket. Please get out, child. He got out. And he broke out at a crazy hospital with a crazy girl that always wanted to break out. And she told him that he was trying to get out, and she helped him out, right? She said, you're not the only one that's always want to break out. Like, and that remind me of, okay, this is going to be a really, really short story because I am finished. But it just came up because it reminded me of that, this particular scene that was from a memory. I used to, of course, I know, let's say it together, used to be a florist. Making deliveries. I had an FTD order, and I had to take it to the hospital, child. And it wasn't a regular hospital. It was a hospital for the mentally unstable. And it was crazy. It was crazy. When I'm not point intended. Did I say that right? No point intended. Once I realized I was going to like a place, you know, that have mentally unstable people. I told my daughter she was going in and make the delivery with me. So we goes in there and they tell us where to go, and we go through different doors, and we finally get to a door where we was making a delivery. And in this particular place, I guess this person got sick and they was in like a hospital bed. So we made the delivery to that person, and me and my daughter was like, we saw people in the hallways. We saw people like literally like just facing a wall and kind of, I don't want to say holding on to the wall, but they were just like at the wall, just like. So I was telling my daughter, I said, okay, whatever you do, don't stare, don't look at nobody, just walk as fast as you can. So my daughter was like, Mom, I feel a little scared. I was like, you ain't gotta be scared. They just, you know, this is their home. We out of place. So we need to just not, like, have no attention, right? So me and Aiden walking down the hall, right? And then all of a sudden, she saw this little old lady. And a little old lady was holding on to, like, a railing. And Aiden was like, oh, that's so sad. I was like, Nadine, don't look at nobody, keep walking. window, and I was like, walk past. So we was walking, and we pushed the door, this button you push, and it opened up. The lady was walking with us, and she was, so we start running, right? She start running with us, and I was like, oh my God, what do we do? She's gonna break out. She was holding on to Nadine. Nadine said, I'm sorry, I can't take you with me. Just like, no, take me with you. So I was backing out, and I was going through the door, leaving Nadine behind. And then this nurse came up to me and Nadine and the old lady and said, oh, I'm so sorry, sweetie. You know, I got her. It's okay. She was like, but I wanted to go. They were going to take me with them. And Nadine was like, started telling the nurse that Nadine was gonna break her out, just like she was gonna take me with her. She was taking me with her. Nadine just looking like that. Nadine was so shooken up. And then after the lady says, okay, y'all can go. We goes out the door. They shut the door. They got like these little windows. And the lady was at the window knocking on the window. Don't leave me. So Nadine gets in the car and she's like, oh, Mom, I feel kind of sad. I was like, yeah, that is kind of sad. And then we fell out, child. We fell out. I said, Nadine, she told the nurse she was going to break her out. Nadine said, that's it.
Testing 1, 2, 1, 2. It's been a long day. You just want to go away. You can't sleep at night. And now I'm here. I can't promise tomorrow. But you're going to feel out of day. We can tingle it away. Now I'm here.